The title of this painting is Arts Day Sarasota, and it's a very large mural size work. It's 60 by 72 inch oil on canvas. Before I get into the painting, I'd like to talk a little bit about its background. During these early 90s, when we were traveling quite a bit and I was doing these what they call genre street scene paintings from Paris and London and Ireland and Amsterdam, Bangkok, Susan and I were talking one evening and said, you know, we live in Sarasota and we do have a little gallery downtown, a studio gallery, as well as the studio on Siesta Key. And I had never done a street scene in Sarasota. So I decided that this was at the beginning of 1994. And in January every year, the city of Sarasota has a big festival, which they call Arts Day. And essentially, they rope off, the entire downtown area, and they put art exhibits, music, all kinds of fun activities that starts like at 11 in the morning and goes till 8 o'clock at night. So this particular year, we were open at the studio. My studio gallery is over on the left, and you can see me and my friend Sidney Weiss, who ran the gallery for us, over on the left. Also, behind them is my wife and two of our friends. But I chose this particular scene because of all the music and entertainment that was that day. This group that's singing on the stage was just fantastic. There's five singers and a drummer and a guitar player, and they were the epitome of what Sarasota Arts Day is all about. I mean, you can see, you can actually see the energy on the stage. You can see the energy of the people in the audience clapping their hands. Everybody's focused on that. People are coming in from the other part of the city to come down and enjoy this particular music. So I was doing some sketches and also a lot of photos, and this was the composition that I came up with. Now, if you see, in addition to all the energy in the foreground, there is typical a Sarasota background with the sun, as you can see, highly exaggerated, the yellows and the whites, and then there's some formal perspective with the palm trees and the other trees fading out, and the street going off into the distance with the people coming towards us. Also, the building on the upper right, if you look closely, it says Opera House. And the funny thing about this painting, when I was actually doing it, I got a little tired about the painting, and my son-in-law, I hired him to paint Opera House, so he gets credit for this. At any rate, there's a story behind this opera house. It's one of the older buildings in Sarasota, and the legend has it that in 1954, Elvis Presley made his first public appearance outside of Mississippi, where he grew up, at the Opera House. Now, and it's supposedly a true story, but it shows you basically some of the history in Sarasota, and there is still, you know, some real traditions and some of the old Sarasota that is still around even today. But back in the 90s, it was more so. In front of that is a little green building which was called Limerick Junction Pub. It was owned by a couple of friends of ours from Dublin, and it was the best Irish pub in the city, probably the only Irish pub in the city at the time. But they had good food, and it was a fun place, and we would spend a lot of time there. Again, it's a classic old building. It's no longer the pub, but it's still there. And to the left of that, in the middle, is this white building, the Bijou Restaurant, another place that is one of the older buildings and, in fact, still in existence. And it's owned by our friend J.P. Skaggs, and it's a wonderful place, and we spent a lot of time there. Our building, the pink building on the left, was owned by a sculptor friend of mine, Jack Dowd, and he actually bought it a couple years before this painting was done, and he asked me to, you know, if I'd be interested in renting a space downtown, which we did. And there's a barbershop and another art gallery, and it was just, again, this is one of these old classic traditional buildings that still exist in Sarasota. Now, getting back to the energy and the fun of the people, there's a lot of people in here that I don't need to, you know, mention because you wouldn't know who they are, but a lot of our friends are there. And I also intersperse some characters. So if you look in the middle, in the front row, there's a guy with the beard and a beret. Well, that's Paul Gauguin in my part. And over his shoulder to the left is the guy in the hat and the red beard. Well, that would be Van Gogh. And then just to add some more humor, behind Gauguin, I have my mother with the silver hair. And as I mentioned, Susan and I are in the foreground with a couple of her friends, and the owner of the building, Jack, is back there walking down the street with his beautiful wife, Jill. So the painting was eventually written up in the Sarasota Herald Tribune and then purchased by some very serious collectors of mine, John and Mary Louise Toll, who spend time between Sarasota and Haverford, Pennsylvania. This is sort of the opposite view from my studio gallery in downtown Sarasota on First Street that we had in the 90s. This is a view from my deck at our house on Siesta Key, where we lived from 1989 to 1999, and where I did a lot of my painting outside. The French use the term in plein air, and it's probably the very best way to get access to just the pure light. And again, when you're outside, it's not necessarily a northern light or a southern light. It's a 360 degree light, which is reflects in the water and the sky. There's probably no place on Earth, at least in America, that could be a better spot to learn about colors, because the colors change every 2 seconds when you're outside. Again, this is a view from my outside studio. I have this little easel is a portable easel. They're called French easels. They were designed back in around 1850 by the Impressionists when they went outside. And the actual design has never changed. It's almost one of those things in life that are absolutely perfect. It folds up into a little briefcase and you can take it anywhere. And I took this all over the place. This traveled with me to Italy, Ireland, England, Asia. It was sort of my next to Susan, my favorite travel companion. Anyway, the following paintings we're going to talk about were painted right from this particular spot, but I thought it'd be interesting just to see the view that I did have. These two paintings here, Sanderling Beach and Sunset in Crimson, are two of the best examples of my painting in the late 80s, early 90s on Siesta Key, Florida. They represent a free use of color that I had never had until I did start painting on the Gulf. And a lot of the paintings that I did were outside, or as they say, in plein air. This first one, Sanderling Beach, was actually a view from my little outside studio and tiki pub. We had a tiki hut pub right on the water. This painting shows an incredible free use of color. If you start with the sky, you see the crimsons, the yellows, the purple. I mean, it's just about every shade of the rainbow in the sky, and it blends into the trees. And these are little cabanas that were on the beach that was adjacent to our property. The cabanas, kind of a funky little places that people use for the swimming, and the rocks and the water combine to make this quite an interesting composition. And again, the free use of color, this is what I was everything you do in painting is a search, but this was the breakthrough for freedom, which I've developed over the years. This was one of the first examples, as well as the one next to it, which is called Sunset and Crimson. Now, if you look at this sunset, this was actually an oil painting that I did from several watercolors. What I would do, I'm standing, there's a little wall where we're standing at my studio, actually at our house, and I would tape watercolor paper, 12 by 14 inch watercolor, and as the sun was setting, I would do four or five of these. I would just move along as the sun set, and every one of the watercolors was different because the colors would be constantly changing. Anybody that's watched a sunset knows that. But a lot of people never had been fortunate enough to see the sunsets. That when you live on the Gulf for 20 years like we did, the sun, the suns are so different every day. In this particular one, there was a storm approaching. So you can see the very powerful reds and the violets and the actual little streak of lightning and some beginning of rain, which I use yellow to exaggerate. And of course the reflections in the water and on the trees over on the right, you can see the sun reflecting on the trees. Again, these are very free paintings, very loose. They got into my system by just constant use of color and constantly painting outside, which I can't emphasize enough, is so much different from just doing studio work, because there, it's you are surrounded in a 360 degree circumference of all the light coming from front, back, up, down. And I feel fortunate to have been able to live there at the time and create these works. The Sandaling Beach painting was subsequently purchased by Matt and Lisa Walsh of Longboat Key, who own the Observer Group. And Sunset and Crimson was purchased by one of my major collectors back then, Robert Nealon, who was originally from Boston and settled in Siesta Key.